ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां साक्षात्कृतं दयानंदं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तः शान्तः शान्तिः ॐ नमो भगवते वैवस्वताय मृत्यवे ब्रह्म विद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च The Upanishad, it continues with the story. We have not yet reached the teaching part of the story. That will come as part of the third boon. Nachiketa, he had asked the first boon. Pratamam varam, in the form of going back to earth and to be with his father, wanting to be with his father, and father should recognize, receive and be happy with him. That was the first boon. Second boon, he asked about a specific ritual. That ritual will take one to Swargaloka. He wanted to know the karma, the Vaidika karma, doing which a person can attain Swargaloka. That is what we saw in the previous shloka. Swargalokaha amrutattvam bhajante etadvitiyena vrine varena. Why did he ask that particular boon? Because majority of the people in the earth, they are after sukham, they are after pleasure, they don't want dukkham. Already they are experiencing a lot of dukkham. Sometimes a few drops of sukham in the form of pleasure, in the form of comfort, in the form of gaining the object or the persons what they require. Sometimes it happens. Since they are bombarded with dukkham all the time, they wanted to experience, they wanted to enjoy that which will give them continuous sukham. That is what majority, most of the people in the bhumi, they want. That is why we also add this kama purushartha in our sankalpa. When we do a puja, we always have the sankalpa. Dharmartha, kama, moksha. Kama is important. Even all the karma, any karma you take, even if you go to the temple and offer your puja, when you do sankalpa, you say what you want. And if you see most of them, it will be either artha or kama. So the focus is on only this. Artha is also for the sake of pleasure only. So it's all kama centered. Kama means sukham. Sukha praptyartham. Sarva rishta nivrityartham. Sarva abhishta praptyartham. Sukha praptyartham. That is what the sankalpa is. So therefore, Nachiketa knows this. Since majority of the people are after sukham, and sukham, it is said in the Shastram that you will have it in Swargaloka, he made that as a second boon. Swargaloka ha amrtattvam bhajante, they always enjoy the pleasure, no dukkham there. You teach me that ritual, that agni, swargyam agnim, you teach, because you know, he mrityo tum bhavan adyeshi, adyeshi, you know, therefore you teach me that. You teach me who endowed with Shraddha. Shraddha is important. That is why he said Shraddha Dhanaya Makyam in the previous shloka. You have to believe. You need to have Shraddha in the ritual. If you don't have Shraddha, then either you will not do the ritual or the ritual will be incomplete. Shraddha is the commitment. It is the commitment and in the trust of the words of the Shastra. The Shastra as Shastra tells that if you do a particular karma, that will give you a particular benefit. If you do the karma with all the ingredients, with all the things necessary, with all the things which the Shastra says, all these things should be offered as ahuti, and so many priests should be there, and this should be done on a particular time and a particular place. So if you follow a particular mantra also to be chanted when you offer ahuti, when you do a karma with all the conditions as stipulated by the Shastram, that will give the benefit, that will give its phalam. Karma is there, therefore karma phalam definitely must be there. Avashyam bhavi. That is why even in Mundaka Upanishad, in the beginning, first Mundaka, second section itself, tadetat satyam. There satyam is that Upanishad doesn't talk about the truth. That Upanishad doesn't talk about the Atma Vidya, Brahma Vidya. That satyam is not talked about. Tadetat satyam mantreshu karmani kavayo yanya pashyan. Mantreshu talks about the karma, the ritual, that is done with the mantra and with the ahuti. That result is avashyam bhavi. It will definitely happen. That ritual will give you the definite karma palam. If you do with Shraddha and do as the Shastra says, then it is bound to give its result. Because Shastra being a pramanam, and when it says something, it will happen. Because Shastra, the words of the Shastra are the words of Bhagavan. And that being a pramanam, that will definitely give the result. That is called Shraddha. Shastra is a pramana not only to know the tatparyam, not only to know the tattvam, the truth, the absolute truth. Shastram is also pramanam for gaining certain ends, doing certain rituals. For the accomplishment of dharma, artha, kama also, Shastra provides a varieties of karma, which Shastra only provides. Therefore, Shastra is a pramanam for karmakanda also. When Shastra is a pramanam, we say, it is not pramanam with regard only to the Vedanta, Upanishads. It is a pramanam with regard to karmakanda also. Since Veda is divided into two parts, karmakanda and jnanakanda, jnanakanda gives you atmavidya. Atmavidya cannot be gained by any other means of knowledge that we have seen. Similarly, karmakanda also. What karmakanda teaches, that cannot be taught, that cannot be gained by any other pramanam. Why? There are certain means and certain ends. Means are called sadhanam. Sadhyate anena iti sadhanam. Sadhanam, that by which something is accomplished, is called sadhanam. It means means. Sadhya. Sadhya is end. Ends. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. They are all sadhya. How to attain that? That is the means. So there are various means and various ends. Certain means we know, and the ends for those means also we know. Certain means and certain ends we know. By doing a particular sadhana, you get a particular sadhyam. We know that by other pramanams. Pratyaksha, anumana, upamana. We know that. For example, if you want to go to Australia and do higher study, that is your sadhyam to be done. So what is the means for that? The means for that you should be a qualified person and prepared enough, and you should have the visa and whatever the things are required. That is the means. Once the means are complete, the ends will be achieved. Then you can go. So a means are known and the ends are known. And for this, we don't need any special pramana. Means and ends are known. But there are certain ends, for those ends, we don't know the means, the sadhanams, we don't know. Unknown means, but the known end. Similarly, there are certain unknown ends, and the means are also unknown. Sadhanam is also not known, sadhyam is also not known. Sadhanam is not known, sadhyam is known. For example, for the known sadhyam, an unknown sadhanam provided by the Shastra. Suppose a couple wants a child. They did not have putra bhakyam. So sadhyam is they want children, they want child. So that is sadhyam. The end. So what is the sadhanam for that? If a couple wants a child, the sadhanam, the means are, either they have to consult a doctor, that is what we know, consult a doctor or undergo some medical treatment, something. But Shastram gives a sadhanam which is not known by any other pramanam. Shastram tells you do a particular ritual, putra kameshti yaga, you do, doing which you get a child, progeny. Putra Kameshti, again, how do you know that Putra Kameshti? How do you come across the Putra Kameshti? Can you come across by Pratyaksha Pramanam or Anum? Can you guess? If I do Putra Kameshti Yajna, I will get. It is not within the range of any Pramanam. Only Shastra Pramanam comes to help. Only through Shastra we come to know doing a particular ritual, doing that particular Putra Kameshti Yajna, the progeny is gained. And there are a lot of evidences that ritual, when it is done, it has given result. It has given result to some people. So, Shastram is a pramanam for that. So, the sadhanams are not known, but sadhyam is known. Similarly, sadhanam is also not known, sadhyam also not known. For example, Swarga Loka. To go to Swarga Loka, what will you do? What pramanam will help you? Again, here the other pancha pramanam cannot help. Pancha pramanam, pratyaksha, anumana, upamana, anupalabdhi, arthapatti. These five pramanas cannot help you to know the unknown means, to gain the unknown end. Sadhanam, for example, if you want to go to Swargaloka is sadhyam. Do you know how Swargaloka will be? No. If you want to know how Swargaloka is, then we should not be in, then we should not, we have to leave this earth. If you want to go to Swargaloka, you have to leave the body here. If you leave the body, then you cannot come and tell how Swargaloka will be. So it is not possible. Swargaloka can be known with a particular upadhi, with a particular body, mind, senses, for which you have to drop this upadhi, what you have now. So you don't have any idea about Swargaloka. None of the pramanams can help you in gaining the knowledge of how the Swargaloka will be. Only Shastra says there is something called Swargaloka, there is something called Narakaloka. Not only Swargaloka, it talks about the seven lokas up and seven lokas down. There are 14 lokas there. All these lokas, the knowledge of those lokas are gained only through the Shastram. So that means the sadhyam, sadhyam, the ends are not known, which are known only by the Shastram. And if you want to go to Swargaloka, how to go to Swargaloka? Can we go by a rocket? Can we adopt any scientific modern inventions and go to Swargaloka? Not possible. So to go to Swargaloka, the sadhyam, which is unknown, known only by the Shastram, and the Shastram itself provide the means, the unknown means provided by the Shastram, the sadhanam. What is a sadhanam? You do a particular ritual. That particular ritual will take you to Swargaloka after death. So, with regard to going to Swargaloka, Shastra provides a ritual. Here, both the sadhyam, the end, and the sadhanam are known only by the Shastram. We come to know the means and the end only by the Shastram. So Shastram is a pramana, is eva pramanam. So with regard to Karmakanda also, Shastram is the only pramanam. And therefore, here, Nachiketa, he wanted to take this knowledge of Swarga Prapti to Bhuloka. He wanted to gain that knowledge from Yamadharma Raja and take it to Bhuloka, because Yamadharma Raja is a jnani. He knows everything. He knows the whole Shastram. So definitely he must be knowing this particular ritual also. Since the sadhanam is, the means are not known and the ends are also known to some extent to the Shastram for Nachiketa. Therefore, he wanted to know this sadhanam, doing which people can reach Swargaloka. So therefore, he asked that as a second boon. Etadvitiyena vrine varena. So that knowledge which Yamadharma Raja is going to give. What knowledge? That knowledge regarding the ritual. when it comes to ritual, that is dealt separately by the Karmakanda. Karmakanda portion of the Veda deals with the rituals. Karma. Varieties of karmas are there. It's a highly voluminous portion of the Veda. Only the Vedanta is a small portion. At the end, you will find a small portion. At the end of each Veda, each Shaka, you will find a small portion, that is Vedanta. Why Veda has got such a voluminous Karmakanda portion? Because most of us are interested in Dharma, Artha, Kama. Rarely, a few people are interested in Moksha. That is why Veda also gives you a lot of karma. And Vedas provides those karmas, those sadhanams, unknown sadhanams for certain known sadhyam or unknown, and also unknown sadhyam. For both, the sadhanams are provided by the Vedas. So now here, Nachiketa is asking, Swargyam Agnim, the ritual, the karma, which will take one to Swargaloka. And that Yamadharma Raja is going to teach him. That is the next shloka. I will chant, you can repeat after me.
Prate brabhimi tadume nibodha.
Prate brabhimi tadume nibodha.
Swargyamagnim nachiketah prajanan.
Swargyamagnim nachiketah prajanan.
Ananta lokapti matho pratishtham.
Ananta lokapti matho pratishtham.
Vidhitva metan nihitam guhayam.
Vidhitva metam nihitam guhayam.
Okay. You can mute your mic now. I'll give the word by word meaning also. So you can note down the word by word meaning. That will be helpful when you are reading the mantra. You can understand the meaning of the mantra if you know the word by word meaning. In the previous mantra also I gave, but I didn't tell specifically, but when I explained the meaning of the mantra, the meaning was given. So here, Yamadharma Raja, he says that I will teach you the ritual, the karma. And this karma is going to be an elaborate and a difficult karma. Therefore, Yamadharma Raja says, yeah, you listen to me very carefully. Note every point of my statement. And as I told before, the word Agni has got different meanings. Agni literally referring to the physical fire, which is kindled in the Omakunda. That is Agni. And another Agni is the Agni refers to the ritual as such, the karma, that is Agni. Swargyam Agnim, that is what Nachiketa asks. Swargyam Agnim, the Agni which takes to Swarga. Swargyam Agnim, Swargaya Agnim, Swargyam Agnim, that which is conducive to conduce you to take to Swargaloka, Swargyam Agnim. That is the second meaning. The third meaning also, it is there. The third meaning is called Virat. The third meaning of the word Agni is Virat. What is Virat? Virat is Vishwarupa Ishvara. Bhagavan who is present in the form of the universe, that is Virat. Bhagavan in the form of all the gross shariram, gross body, whether it is human body or any body, the gross prapancha, stula prapancha. Bhagavan in the form of the whole stula prapancha is what referred by the word Virat. Virat is a technical word. Samashti stula prapancha chaitanyam is called Virat. Samashti means collective, total. Vyashti means individual. In Tattva Bodha we saw Prajnyaha, Tejasaha, Vishvaha. Stula Sharira Abhimani Atma is called Vishvaha. We saw that. Stula Sharira Abhimani Atma. Atma is Chaitanyam, consciousness. Chaitanyam is better. It is used Atma or Chaitanyam. Chaitanyam, which is identified with the gross individual body, is called Vishva. The technical name, Vishva. You being nothing but Chaitanyam, you are Chaitanya Swarupam, Atma. When identified with the individual gross body, is called Vishva. In the waking state, in the Jagrat Avastha, you are identified with your gross body. You as an individual and you Atma. As an individual, when I say you, divide off all the upadis. You means only you. No more, no adjectives. You means not your name, not your form, not your shape, not your body, not the whole biography of you. You without any qualifiers. That is the you. That is Atma, Chaitanyam. Identified with the physical shariram, the gross body, individual gross body, that is called Vishva. So Vishva is nothing but Atma. But with reference to the physical, individual physical body is called Vishva. In the Jagrat Avastha, in the waking state. Similarly, Taijasa, the individual subtle body, Sukshma Shariram. You have got Stula Shariram, you have got Sukshma Shariram. How do you know you have got Sukshma Shariram? When you go to the sleep, when you are in dream state, you have a body. You enjoy the dream world with your dream body. In the dream, you create your own world. Your own world of objects and things and people and situation, and you enjoy. You are a bhokta. The dream universe is created by you, and you are the creator of the dream universe, and you enjoy the dream universe. Enjoy doesn't mean only sukham, but that dukkham is also an experience that is called enjoyment, bhoga. So that subtle body, sukshma shariram, even when we say if the prana leaves the body, the person dies, physical body is here. What happened to the person is sukshma shariram leaves the body. Physical body is here, sukshma has left the body. So that it means that clearly shows sukshma is different, stula is different. As long as sukshma is in association, in contact with the stula, stula is active. And once the sukshma lives, stula is inert. That is why we call it a body, just a body, not the person. We don't refer to a dead body as a person, it's the body. So we don't call the body with the name anymore. It's just the body. Because it is without life, the sukshma shariram has left. So that is a sukshma. Sukshma Shariram. So the Chaitanyam associated with the Sukshma Shariram, it is called Taijasa. the technical name, Taijasa. Similarly, the Chaitanyam associated with the Karana Shariram. Karana is the causal body. That which is the cause for the subtle body as well as the gross body is called Karana Shariram. And the Chaitanyam Atma associated or identified with the Karana Shariram causal body is called Prajnaha. So this is with regard to the individual, Vyashti. Similarly, with regard to the the prapancha, the collective, samashti, with regard to samashti, the total, the collective, there are three levels. Individual is jivatma, collective is paramatma, Bhagavan, Ishvara. And there, paramatma, Chaitanyam identified with the gross physical universe. Samashti Stula Prapancham is called Virat or Vaishvanara. So Virat is Ishvara, Bhagavan, Bhagavan only Virat. And Bhagavan also, that Virat also, that Chaitanyam associated with this Samashti Sukshma Prapancha has got a name that is called Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha is the cause of Virat. From Sukshma Samashti Sukshma Prapancha, Samashti Stula Prapancha has come. From Hiranyagarbha, Virat has come. So, with like the individual body, like the Vyashti, like the individual. Similarly, we have these three in Samashti also. So here, the word Virat, it refers to Samashti, Stula, Prapancha, Atma, which is Ishvara or Bhagavan. Ishvara, when I say, that is Ishvara, Bhagavan. Bhagavan, who is Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karanam, and who has created this universe, and who is within the universe, who has become the universe, that is Ishvara, that is Virat. And that also we present in three stages, like Karana, Samashti Karana Sharira Atma, Samashti Sukshma Sharira Atma, and Samashti Stula Sharira. Samashti Stula is Prapancha, the whole, the universe, the whole, the collective comes. So here, the word Agni, it refers to Virat, Vaishvanara, the Samashti Stula Prapancha Atma Ishvara. So that is the another meaning of the word Agni. So when we say Samashti, Stula, Prapancha, Chaitanyam, Ishvaraha, that Ishvara is the Adhara of the whole Prapancha. The whole Prapancha as its base, as its Adharam, as its sustenance, for its creation, sustenance, resolution, everything for that, Adhara is Virat only. So the Agni is, that Agni has got the another meaning, Virat. That is why is Yamadharma Raja is going to say Pratishtam. He says Pratishtam. Pratishta is the Adhara. Okay. We'll look into the mantra now. So this 14th mantra is the statement of Yamadharma Raja. Prate Bravimi Tadume Nibodha Swargyamagdim Nachiketah Prajanan. Yet Nachiketaha is there. Nachiketaha is not the Pratama Bhakti Ekavachanam. Nachiketaha, Nachiketat, Nachiketau, Nachiketaha. No, not like Ramashabda. It is Nachiketaha is Sambodhana. It is addressing Nachiketa. Achiketa is, he is one who asked the question, who wanted to know the ritual. So, Yamadharma Raja replying to Nachiketa, addressing him, "Ho Nachiketa, hey Nachiketa, hey Nachiketaha, hey Nachiketaha, brevimi, brevimi." Brevimi is, I tell you, brevimi. Prate brevimi. What is prate brevimi? Pra is upasarga. In between the upasarga and the word brevimi, pra and brevimi, te has come. So Upanishad has the privilege to separate the upasarga and put the upasarga somewhere and the kriyapadam somewhere. So here it has done that. Pra te brevimi. What we can do is connect the pra to brevimi and say prabravimi. Prabravimi. Prakarshena brevimi. I tell you elaborately. I will tell you clearly. Prakarshena brevimi. Te is to you. To you, I tell you elaborately. What? Svargyam agnim. That is the karma. The object of teaching is svargyam agnim. Svargyam, conducive for Surgaloka. Svargyam, Surgaya, Surga Sadhanam, Surga Pradam. That takes one to Svarga. That leads to Svarga. That is Svargyam. What? Agnim. Agnim is the karma, the ritual. So, Svargyam Agnim, Te Brevimi. I teach you the ritual, the Agni. That is a ritual which takes one to Svarga Loka. Prajanan, Jadatu. Ja means to know, Jan to know. So, Prajanan, I who knows the Svargyam Agnim, I will teach you. So, Prajanan, I who knows, Prajanan means Vijnatavan. I who knows, I am very well informed about the ritual. Vijnatavan agam. I who knows the ritual very well, Prajanan, Vijnatavan agam, te Svargyam Agnim Brevimi, he Nachiketa, Nachiketaha. O Nachiketa, I who is well informed about the ritual will teach you elaborately. Te Nachiketa. Tadu me nibodha. Tat u me nibodha. U is a particle. It just added. It doesn't have any meaning. Tat me nibodha. Tat nibodha. Tat refers to what I am going to teach. Svargyam Agnim. Nibodha, you learn. Tat nibodha, you learn from me. This nibodha we saw in the meaning also we saw in the Gita, first chapter itself. Asmakam tu visishtaye tan nibodha dvijottama. Sanyatan tan brevimite. Asmakam tu visishtaye tani bodha vijottama nayakamama sainyasya tan sanyartam tan brevimite. There also nibodha and brevimi, it comes together. In that Gita, first chapter shloka, there also nibodha brevimi. It's just a coincidence. Here also nibodha is there, brevimi is there. Okay. So nibodha, tat me nibodha, me is from me. From me, you learn. Makhyam. From me, you learn. What? Svargyam Agnim. E Nachiketaha. Svargyam Prajanan. Svargyam Agnim. Te Brevimi. Tat Me Nibodha. So, I teach you that Agni. You learn that from me. Mama Vachasaha. Nibodha buddhyasva. From my words, you learn, you understand. How? That is not given here. Shankara Bhagavatpada, in his commentary, he says, Ekagramanaha, with the mind focused, with a concentrated mind, you buddhyasva, you learn from me. What? Svargaya hitam, svarga sadhanam agnim, that is svargyam agnim enachiketa. Svargaya hitam, that which is the means, which is conducive to take to svargaloka, svarga sadhanam, that which is the means. Here says svarga sadhanam, the means to go to svargaloka, you learn from me. From me, who is well informed. Prajanan vijnatavan agam asmi. So, tan nibodha. So, here brevimi nibodha, these words are there. That shows that Yamadharma Raja, he wanted his student Nachiketa to listen with concentration. Your mind should not go here and there. Don't do any parallel activities. You focus your mind on my teaching. I will teach you elaborately. You listen to me. That is the meaning of the first two lines. Then the second line is the qualifiers. They describe about the Agni. Ananta lokapti matho pratishtam vidhitvametam nikitam guhayam. So this is the praise of the Agni, the ritual. Agnim stauti. Yamadharma Rajaha Mrityuhu Agnim Stauti. Mrityu, he praises the Agni. What does he say? Ananta Lokapti Atho Pratishtam. Ananta Lokaptim. That is, here also he says Ananta Loka. Loka which is Ananta. Loka which is Ananta. Ananta is unlimited, endless. That which is permanent forever, that is Ananta. When you say unlimited, infinite, it means it doesn't have any end, it is not subject to any limitation. Therefore, it is forever existent. Ananta, the word Ananta indicates that. Ananta Loka. Loka is there. How can a Loka be Ananta? That is contradictory. Any Loka you take, any Loka is to be reached. Whether it is Bhuloka or Swargaloka, any Loka, it involves travel. Traveling from place to place, one place to other place, that is Loka. All the 14 Lokas, they have a location. And they say Ananta Loka. What is in Ananta Loka? Is it not contradictory? So, if you take literally Ananta Loka, endless world, then it's talking about the Swargyam Agnim. And therefore, doing that Agni, you go to Swargaloka. And that Swargaloka is Ananta Loka, he says. How can Swargaloka be Ananta Loka? If Swargaloka is Ananta Loka, then going to Swarga will become the moksha. But that is not the meaning here. Ananta Loka here also, as we saw in the previous class, it is only relatively infinite. You have to take that. That is why in the previous shloka mantra itself, we have seen that Swargalokaha Amrutattvam, that Amrutattvam is also Apekshika Amrutattvam. Similarly, here also Ananta Loka is only a relatively endless. If it is endless, the people who lives in the Loka also will live forever. It is endless. When something is endless, unlimited, then it becomes a satyam of that vastu. That becomes the satyam, the real nature, the substance of that. That cannot be. And we are referring to a Loka. And the Loka has to be reached. It is subject to time. It is subject to space. Then how can it be Ananta? How can it be unlimited? It is not possible. Therefore, here also, Ananta Loka means Swarga Loka, which is relatively superior compared to the Bhuloka. That is the meaning. So therefore, Bhagavad Pada interprets the word Swargaloka Palaprapti Sadhanam Ityetat. Swargaloka. Anantaloka is Swargaloka. Swargaloka is not Ananta. Anantaloka is Swargaloka, which is relatively eternal. So, Anantalokapti Mato Pratishtam. Swargaloka Palaprapti Sadhanam. The Sadhanam, the means for gaining the Swargaloka, which is infinite, relatively infinite. Okay, Anantaloka Aptimato Pratishtam. Pratishtam refers to the Agni. The Agni, which is the Pratishtam, which is the support of the whole universe. So when the word Pratishtam indicates that the Agni doesn't mean literally the fire. Fire cannot be the meaning of the word Agni because of these words, Pratishtam. How can we take the meaning of the word Agni as fire when Pratishtam is there? Pratishtam meaning the support of the whole universe. So therefore, literal meaning of Agni meaning fire cannot be taken here. So that is dropped. Then, can we take the meaning of the ritual, the Vaidika karma? Karma being what it is limited. It cannot be the Adhara of the whole Prapancha. Karma also cannot be the Adhara. It cannot be the Pratishta of the whole universe. So that meaning also we cannot take. So second meaning of the word Agni also to be dropped. Therefore, we have to take the third meaning of the word Agni, which means Virat. Virat Ishvara. Virat, who is the Adhara, who is the support, who is the supporter, Ashrayam of the whole universe. The whole universe resides in whom? Without whom the universe cannot exist, would not have come into existence. That Virat is what is denoted by the word Pratishtam. The whole Prapancha as its Ashrayam, Ashtayam on whom? Virat. On Virat Ishvara. That is what the meaning of the word Agni. That Agni. Anantaloka. That Agni which will take you to Swargaloka. Anantaloka Prapti Sadhanam. And Vidhi. Vidhi is you know. From Etam Vidhi, you know that. And one more qualifier is there. Nigitam Guhayam. Nigitam Guhayam. So Nigitam is located, which is located. Stitam. Stitam Vityartaha. Nigitam is located. Guhayam. Guha is Guha. Gufa. Guha is literally cave. Literally it means cave. But here Hridaya Guha. We have to take it as a Hridaya Guhayam Nikitam, in the heart cave of the people who do this ritual, who do this Agni, in the heart of the Upasakas, meaning the heart of the people who know this Vidya, who knows the Vidya. The Vidya which is known by those people. Vidusham Buddhau Nivishtam. In the Vidusham, Vidusha is the people, the great people who knows this Vidya. Tasmin Teshu Buddhau Nivishtam. Vidusham Buddhau Nivishtam. That which resides, which is located in the heart of the Upasakas. That which is the Adhara of the whole universe, that which is conducive to take to Anantaloka, Swargaloka, that Agni, that Virat Agni, Vidhi, you know that. I'll teach you know that. So Anantaloka Apti Sadhanam, and that is Agni Sadhanam, that is Agni. That Agni which is the Pratishta, which is the Adhara of the whole Prapancha, and that Agni which is located in the heart of the whole universe, because everything being the Virat, everything has come out from Virat Ishvara. So therefore, this whole Samashti Stula Prapancha is nothing but Virat. It is the manifestation of Virat Ishvara. Therefore, it is said it is located in the heart of all the people, and that Agni, I will teach you, Agam Bravimi, May Nibodha, you learn from me. So that is what the Yamadharmaraja says in this mantra. Then Yamadharmaraja is going to elaborate the ritual that you will not find in the Kaṭhopaniṣat. Upanishad being the last portion and of the Veda, and talks about the Vidya which gives you moksha. Therefore, it doesn't deal with the ritual, the karma. Even though Nachiketa asked this particular ritual as a second room from Nachiketa, from Yamadharmaraja, and Yamadharmaraja also going to describe, but that description you will not find in Kaṭhopaniṣat. For the details of those descriptions, probably you have to go to the Karmakanda portion of the Veda, that which we are not interested. So Upanishad, since Upanishad is not interested in presenting the details of the ritual, Upanishad is not going to deal with that. Therefore, Upanishad is just going to finish the whole ritual in one mantra. That's it. Somebody asked this question. How is that Upanishad teaches the ritual in the end portion, in the Vedanta? In the Vedanta, you will not find. No details of the ritual will be found in the Jnanakanda portion of the Veda. Those details, if you want, you have to go to the Karmakanda. Since we are Vedanta students, we are not interested in that. We are not interested in going to Svargaloka. We are interested in being free now itself, here and now, not after death. So, now Yamadharmaraja is going to give him the knowledge of that particular Agni, and within one mantra the whole knowledge is given. That Upanishad doesn't give the details, some information Upanishad gives. So I will chant the mantra, you can repeat. Lokadi magnim tamuva chatasmai.
Lokadi magnim tamuva chatasmai.
Ya ishtaka yavatirva yathava.
Ya ishtaka yavatirva yathava.
Sacha pitat pratyavadadyatoktam.
Sachapi tatritya vadadyatoktam.
Athasya mrityah punarevah tushtah.
Atasya mrityu punarevaha
tushtah.
Tushtah.
I don't know, the swara itself has changed. I don't chant like this. Lokadimagnim tamuvajatasmai. Ya ishtaka yavatirva yathava. Sachapitat pratyavadadyatoktam. Atasya mrityu punarevah tushtah. Anyway, this we don't have swara, but in a particular way I chant. Somehow I missed it today. Okay. You can mute your mic now. So, this mantra is going to talk about the ritual. Okay. So, Yamadharmaraja is giving the details. Lokadim agnim. Lokadim agnim tasmai uvacha. I'll give the meaning of the words of the mantra. The meaning in general will be seen later, the next class. Uvacha we know. Uvacha told. Tasmai uvacha, to him he told. Who told whom? Yamadharmaraja told Nachiketas. What did he tell? Agnim. Agnim is the ritual. Lokadim agnim. that lokadis is important. Lokadim agnim tam uvacha. He told the lokadim agnim. The agni, which is the lokanam adihi, that is lokadihi. Here we can take the agni, which is the superior agni. Superior agni of all the worlds, he taught. The lokadim, that word has to be interpreted. We can give two meanings for that. We will see that when we see in detail. So here we can take that the agni, which is foremost in the world, was that Yamadharmaraja taught Nachiketa. Tasmi uvacha. And the details are given. Ya ishtakaha, yavatirva yataha, ya ishtakaha. Ishtaka means bricks. Ishtaka means bricks. Ishtaka is akaranta strilinga. Ishtaka, ishtake, ishtakaha. Ishtaka is bricks. You would have observed when they construct a yajna kunda. Yajnakunda is constructed with bricks. And Yajnakunda, you will find different in different shapes. Rectangular will be there, circular will be there, and different shapes of Yajnakunda depending on the Devata. It is constructed with bricks. So Ya Ishtaka. And there is a particular way those Yajnakundas should be constructed. It's all given. Those details are given in the Karmakanda, how the Yajnakundas should be constructed and how many bricks should be used, what are the bricks should be used, and when you bake the brick, what are the mantra to be chanted, and for the brick, from where the mud means that mud should be pure, and some mantra should be chanted, and how the mud is converted to bricks. So all the process, you know, that everything is given. What mantra should be chanted, and what is the shape and the dimension of the bricks. That details are also given. All these details, intricate details, are given in the Veda. It's Veda. So this construction of Yajna Kunda itself is a geometry. So that is why we have this Vaidika geometry also, it is there. So there is a particular way. We cannot construct as we like, because we are going to perform a ritual. You just put few bricks on four sides and put Haguti in the middle. It is not like that. So there is a procedure from the construction, from the shape of the Omakanda to the shape of the bricks. Everything is all those intricate details are given by the Veda itself. So Ishtaka is bricks. Ya Ishtaka. Ya Ishtakaha Bhavanti. What types of bricks should be used? So it means there are different types of bricks, or different types of bricks are there. So therefore, Ya Ishtaka, what type of bricks should be used? And Yavatirva Yathava. Yavatihi va. And how many bricks should be used, whether odd number of bricks should be used or even number, all depends on the Devata. All depend on the Devata. So yavati hiva, how many bricks should be used, and etava bhavanti, and how it should be constructed, how the Omakanda should be constructed. So all the details with regard, starting from the construction of Omakunda, covering the whole mantra which are offered while giving oblations, and on the whole Purnahuti mantra, probably everything Yamadharmaraja would have taught to Nachiketas. Those details are not given here. Simply he says, Ya Ishtakaha Yavatirva Yatava. He taught only that particular line covers the whole ritual. You will find no other line. You will find no other information with regard to the ritual except this line. Ya ishtakaha yavatirva yatava. That much. That is the karma Which the that is the karma details which the Upanishad gives. That's it. Ya ishtakaha yavatirva yatava. From that we can infer Yamadharma Raja provided all the details regarding the karma. Yamadharma Rajaha tasmai nachiketaya lokadim agnim uvacha ya ishtakaha yavatihi yatava. That much. Then what happened after that? Sachapi tat pratyavadat yatha uktam pratyavadat yatha uktam sachapi saha cha api tat pratyavadat saha referring to Nachiketa cha api he also who Nachiketas also yatha uktam yathoktam as it was taught to him pratyavadat he repeated. So that is the greatness of Nachiketa and also the teacher. The teacher would have taught him, Madharma Raja would have taught him the details of the karma. After teaching him, probably would have asked Nachiketa to repeat to make sure that he understood what he taught, and Nachiketa also he repeated word by word verbatim to Yamadharma Raja what he taught. Pratyavadat prati avadat, avadat means to speak, avadat langlakara vad to speak, avadat he spoke, he told. Pratyavadat means He repeated verbatim what Yama taught him. Pratyavadat. Yatha uktam, as it was told, pratyavadat. He repeated as it was taught. So that shows Nachiketas had excellent focus of mind. His focus was only in listening to the instruction of the teacher. And what will be the reaction on the part of the teacher now? Athasi mrityuhu punarevaha tushtaha. Tushtaha is santoshaha, santushtaha. He was so satisfied. Asya is prati uccharanena. Because he repeated verbatim, Mrityuhu, Yamadharma Raja, Punaha, Eva Aha. He told again after being satisfied. So happy, Tushtaha son, Yamadharma Raja, Mrityuhu, Punaha, Eva Aha. He told again. Because Nachiketa repeated exactly what he taught, he became so happy and therefore he told again. Mrityuhu aha punaha. He again told. What did he tell? That will come in the next mantra. So this mantra, further details, we will see it in the next class. So we'll stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantih Harih Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harih Om. Thank you.
धन्यवाद.
Any doubts you can ask.
No doubts. Still recording?
Stop it now.
You're not recording, right?